at jobs by the Disney.
It's not quite as pixie dust in every corner. There are security guards and security measures everywhere.
Tonight, the local sheriff says he believes Disney will be reviewing its policy. Gabriel here with NBC News, Lake Buena Vista, Florida.
The tragedy at Disney, of course, not taking place far from the site of the terror attack at an Orlando nightclub. We are learning more about what the gunman's wife says. He told her when he left the house Saturday night and about what she feared. This as video emerges of the killer shot years before the attack. NBC's Miguel Almaguer with more.
Tonight, a clear look at Omar Mateen and the chilling voice of a killer. Working security at the BP oil spill, this video was taken 6 years before Sunday's massacre. At the crime scene, the FBI recovered Mateen's blood-soaked cell phone, which had been sitting in water after a pipe burst during the rain. Feds later collected a computer and camera, but officials say so far the device
is angled too much. I can feel it.
He downloaded terrorist-related material, including sermons from American-born extremist Anwar al-Awlaki. If you know your husband is a terrorist, federal officials say Mateen's wife, Noor Zaki Salman, says her husband told her he was going to visit friends Saturday, but she feared he was going to attack the club. She told officials she pleaded with him not to do anything violent, but never called police.
The story is so awful.
We now know that 2.5 hours before that final encounter, not only did the gunman place 3 phone calls to 911, but he also made one to News 13 in Orlando.
He said, "I'm the shooter. It's me, I'm the shooter."
Police say the gunman told them he would strap explosives to 4 hostages and strategically place them in the corners of the building. Still, some wonder, did police take too long to take the team down?
You finally come in at 5 o'clock in the morning and take this person out? I have a huge issue with that, because within all that time, there was so many bodies in there. People were bleeding to death.
But a former SWAT team instructor says the answers aren't that easy.
The effort team goes in and half of them get taken out. You're not going to be any good to anybody. It's incredibly complex to choreograph and enter.
Tonight, the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, the state agency that oversees the police department, says they are looking into not only the shooting, but also the hostage situation. It's typical in a case like this, but they want to make sure that all procedures were followed.